Are Scrum Masters just facilitators? Or is it a new fancy role for a project manager? And if your team is already doing fine, producing fine, is it a no-brainer to hire a Scrum Master?
I'd better have one more developer than paying a salary to a Scrum Master. She doesn't seem to be doing anything important, and in most of the time, she doesn't seem to be doing anything at all.
The first thing we want to make clear is that the role Scrum Master comes from Scrum, and you may choose to follow any other agile practice, and this is perfectly fine. So the real question is, do you need somebody who is dedicated to the team as a servant leader, focused on delivering the not on delivering the work like everybody else, but on the team's growth and the agile culture? We call that person a Scrum Master, team coach, team facilitator, agile leader, you name it. When we say Scrum Master, we mean any of those.
As the Scrum Master is not producing work done and does not really contribute to the end product, many organizations neglect the need of the role. They either don't have Scrum Masters or just ask some developer, QA or a manager to imitate the role. It's like putting a mask for Halloween, but everybody knows it's you and you're not scaring anyone. The result here is that all these teams are just scratching the basics and they don't really get the continuous improvement culture.
Funny enough, the very same organizations report that they have issues with their team morale and retention, they have bad product quality, they miss almost all of their deadlines, they have many unhappy customers and a lot of wasteful processes. And even if their teams have seemingly sufficient productivity today, nothing really improves in the long term and the big problems are never addressed and solved.
The work of the Scrum Master is often not visible for the naked eye, except if you have a big visible impediment and you can see your Scrum Master going chasing people trying to remove the impediment. Being a servant leader, the Scrum Master supports and facilitates, helps the team to grow. That involves activities like just observing or reflecting on the observations, letting the teams make mistakes and help them learn, foster discussions and retrospectives.
Without a person dedicated to the growth and improvement, your teams will just get to some natural state of their development and will get stuck there. The real high-performing team is the one which gets every single day at least a little bit better than the previous day.
As a conclusion, when you replace your Scrum Master with a developer, you just have one more person focused on the delivery. But if you invest in your Scrum Master, your team can easily double its productivity and efficiency. You will have someone who is constantly focused on the team. Think of it as a machine which needs maintenance and care in order to get more working for.
Okay, if your team is already high-performing, self-managing and continuously improving every 2 weeks or every day even, if that team delivers the highest possible quality every single time, it's capable to remove and actually removes all the blockers and impediments like they were nothing. If you have a product owner and all product owners do amazing job prioritizing and maximizing the value of the product and everyone basically in the organization works in a perfect harmony, then go ahead, fire all the Scrum Masters right away. You don't need them. But if this is not your reality, we advise you to think again.